Hey guys, it's Eddie the Magic Monk. Today I want to talk about how to make the sum function in Excel ignore errors. So let's just create some fake data so I can show you guys the problem. So let's say that I have two columns of numbers. Let's make the first column called Y, the second column called X, and let's just put in some fake numbers. And let's put in some fake numbers here. And then I'm going to create a third column. And I'm going to make the third column equal to the number in the first column divided by the number in the second column. So if I press enter and then if I click on this and fill down, then you can see all of these numbers are generated. So 6 divided by 6 is 1, 4 divided by 7 is 0.57, and so on. But there is a number with an error. So if I want to sum up the numbers in this column, what will happen is if I press equals sum bracket and I highlight these numbers and I finish off the bracket, look what happens. It won't do it. It won't do it because there's an error in one of these numbers. Now, the easiest way to fix that is if you just delete the contents of this cell, then it will add the numbers without that error. But if you don't want to do that, then it's a bit complicated. So what we're going to do is we're going to use another column, and let's call this column Z1. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use an if function. I'm going to say, firstly, let's show you a function called isError. So equals isError. Alright, what this function can do is check whether a number is an error or not. So if you go isError bracket, choose the number on the left, finish the bracket, press enter, and then if you fill this down, what happens is it checks if the number on the left is an error or not. So you can see that all of these numbers here is not an error, so it's got false, but when it hits this cell, it can see that this number is an error, so it says true, and then all of these other ones are false again. So why is this useful? Well, let's change up the formula a little bit. We're gonna say if the number on the left is an error, then we're going to fill in this cell with a blank, so that's written with two quotation marks. However, if it is false, which means if it's not an error, then I will just put in the contents of this cell. So if you finish off with a bracket and fill down again, then it's automatically given us the number on the left without the cell that's an error. So now you can just sum this column. So sum this column and then the cell with the error disappears. And I guess the best way to do this is to preempt the error in your calculation, in your formula in the first place. So if you go back to the formula, instead of just doing that, you can go if D2 divided by E2 is an error, so is error D2 divided by E2, then just show blank, otherwise show d2 divided by e2. So if you preempt that in the first place, then when you fill down, you wouldn't get the error in the first place. So what I'm trying to say is, you guys should try and avoid the error in the first place rather than trying to get the sum function to ignore the error. Now the same thing goes with the average function as well. Okay, thanks for watching guys, see you next time.